Hi, welcome to my tutorials on Euclid's Elements, Book 3. This video presentation is going to be on Proposition 15 of Book 3, which states that of the lines drawn in a circle, the largest line is the one that passes through the center of the circle, or the diameter, and the further the line is away from the center, the smaller it is. So in this example, AD is the largest line because it's through the center of the circle. In other words, it's the diameter. BC is the next largest line since it is closer to the center of the circle than FG. So we have AD is greater than BC is greater than FG. So our proof. First, we will draw our lines perpendicular to the chords. So EK is perpendicular to FG and EH is perpendicular to BC. Now, EH is less than EK because by definition, or because the way we've drawn this, BC is closer to the circle. So if BC is closer to the circle than FG, then EH is smaller than EK. So we will define a point L such that EH is equal to EL. Draw a line perpendicular to EL, and where it intersects the circle is M and N. So from proposition 14 of book 3, because EL is equal to EH, MN is equal to BC. Now we draw the lines from M to N, ME, EN, and so on and so forth. Now looking at this, we have EA and EM are radii of the same circle, so they're equal. Likewise, DE and EN are also equal, since they're radii of the same circle. So if we add them together, we have AE plus ED, or in other words, AD, is equal in length to ME plus EN. If we look at this little triangle here, we have that ME plus EN must be larger than MN, since the sum of two sides of any triangle is larger than the third, according to Proposition 20 of Book 1. So ME plus EN is greater than MN. Now, if MN is less than ME plus EN, and ME plus EN is equal to AD, we have just demonstrated that MN is less than AD. That's the first step of our proof. Now if we look at these two triangles, we have ME is equal to EF, EN is equal to EG, again because they're all radii. We have this angle here, MEN is larger than FEG. And if we have two triangles with two sides that are equal and two sides that are equal, and one has a larger angle than the other, the length opposite the one with the larger angle, in other words MN, will be larger. And this is all according to Proposition 24 of Book 1. So again, these two sides of the triangle are equal, these two sides of these two triangles are equal, we have a larger angle, the one with the larger angle will have the larger base. So we've just shown that FG is less than MN. And if we put them all together, we basically have that FG is less than MN, and MN is less than AD. However, MN in this case, MN was equal to BC, which we've already established up here at the top. So finally, we have this relationship between the lines, which is that the diameter of the circle AD is larger than BC, and since BC is closer to the center, BC is larger than FG, thus demonstrating this proposition. And that concludes this video presentation. To see the next presentation, just click the next button.